Hi, I'm Shreya Veronica, and I'm here with Spencer, the CEO of Stephanie. And today we are going to have an interactive session with him to know about the organization and all about his personal life. So on that note, Spencer, if I could call you the IT tycoon and also a person who inspires many. You have motivated and encouraged many people. And also on that note, if I could share and ask you for questions regarding the same, would you allow me?
Of course, yeah. Absolutely.
So should we start with the questions? Yeah. So how do you introduce yourself? I mean, the company Stephanie.
So I think, company Stephanie and Spencer's story has a lot of similarities. Brazilians, Stephanie is a Brazilian company founded 35 years ago. A technology provider, mm-hmm. technology integrator. It's a group today, more than 30 companies. Mm-hmm. And I have the honor and the privilege to lead North America APAC. Oh. So it's the most important region of the Stephanie Group. Mm-hmm. It's the fast growing region of the Stephanie Group.
Yeah.
Is the group that cooperates. It's the region that brings more opportunities for growth. Because we are in the North American market, it's the market that grows more in the planet.
Okay, so what is the purpose of Stephanie and also the most important values of the company?
So the purpose of Stephanie is helping our clients to succeed and to overcome their challenges. Our mantra is co-creating with our clients mm-hmm. better solutions to a better world.
Okay.
Meaning that we as a company, we want to help our clients and customers to be better as a company and then to provide better services to the world. So this is how we position ourselves. Doing better business, improving the life of the people throughout technology.
Okay. So how does Stephanie set itself apart from the other tech companies?
I think Stephanie sets itself apart being a very entrepreneur type of company.
Mm-hmm.
Marco Stephanie founded by himself Stephanie 35 years ago. So he was the biggest entrepreneur of the company at that time. But what he did that I think is fundamental to the situation that we are today, he kept passing the torch of being an entrepreneur to all of our employees. So not only me, but every single one that works under my management and the rest of the 30,000 employees in the world, they are incentivized to be entrepreneurs in their day-to-day life. So I think that is the difference. We all have ownership. We all have freedom to create, to be creative, to collaborate, and to co-create with our clients.
Okay. So looking ahead, what are your short term, that is the next 2 years, and what are your long term, which is the next 5 year goal?
Right. It's hard to talk about forecasting 5 years in technology nowadays, because technology is changing so fast.
That's true.
But if we take an average of what you're saying, 2 years and 5 years, let's talk about 3 years.
Okay.
If I give numbers to you, North American APAC in 3 years will double the size. We'll double the size in revenues, we'll double the size in profitability.
Okay.
And I'm not sure if it's going to double the size in number of people mm-hmm. because there's no one-to-one correlation mm-hmm. because of the technology, but definitely we're going to grow our number of employees in all the countries, in India, in the Philippines, in China, and United States as well.
Okay.
So growth is one aspect of the forecast for the next 3 years, doubling the size.
Mm-hmm.
The second aspect is the digital transformation. More and more, our clients and our market is going to see the portfolio of solutions of Stephanie mm-hmm. being more digital, more close to the line of business instead of the traditional IT. We are transforming very fast and getting, it's not getting out, but helping our clients to move from the traditional IT to digital IT, putting a lot of emphasis in the user experience and the end-to-end journey, really tapping into the customer's value stream and mm-hmm. helping the customers to change what they need to change that will make sense and give direct effect on their business results.
Okay.
So business agility, mm-hmm. a lot of a business agility in everything that Stefanini is doing right now and will continue heavily during the next 3 years.
Good. How does Stefanini support the community both locally and globally?
Corporate social responsibility is something that it's in our DNA.
Yeah.
You know, we have a Stefanini Foundation.
Mm-hmm.
In other countries, we have been acting in every single community that we are part. In Noida, here in Hyderabad, in China, in U.S., in the suburbs of Detroit.
Mm-hmm.
So we work with another organizations that are helping, you know, minorities, communities in need. So it's something that we do because we love to do, because it is in our, like I said, it's in our DNA.
Mm-hmm.
So I see Stefanini included in all the communities that we are part.
Okay. So moving on further to the Indian organization of mm-hmm. Stefanini. So how many offices do you hold here in India?
So officially in India, we have offices in Noida,
okay.
in Hyderabad, and in Pune.
Okay.
Now think about the reality post-COVID.
Mm-hmm.
Every employee has conditions to work from home.
Yeah.
And you know what? I consider if I have a Stefanini working from home, there's a Stefanini office right there.
Yeah.
So what I'm trying to say is that officially in a building like this, we have three. But our employees, they have a capacity to work from everywhere, from anywhere.
Yeah.
So in that sense, we are in so many places at the same time.
Okay, how many clients do you have in India? And can you mention about the growth in the past years?
Yeah, absolutely. I think we support the majority of the clients that we have in our portfolio from
mm-hmm.
the region are supported from India, both in applications, SAP and non-SAP, and enterprise services. So we're supporting a vast number of clients.
Okay.
From India. The growth over the last years has been amazing. Just giving you numbers, we are around 1,100 employees
mm-hmm.
in India right now.
Okay.
3 years ago, we were 400. So it's a significant growth, and it's more to come.
So what solutions do you offer in India?
I ended up telling about that. So we offered A to Z,
mm-hmm.
but especially applications development and sustain,
mm-hmm.
non-SAP and SAP, SAP traditional, SAP for HANA, S4HANA that we called, on-premises, on-cloud. We do a lot of architecture consulting, business applications development, agile development,
okay.
and we do enterprise services. Enterprise services is the level three of infrastructure
mm-hmm.
when we take care of the entire infrastructure of our clients in order them to operate and have the applications running on top of the infrastructure. So a lot of high added value
okay.
on the services that we provide to
okay.
our clients. I can say that the service provided from India to our clients, it's really critical mission, at what we call in the industry. It's crucial to our clients, the
mm-hmm.
service provided from India to all of them.
Okay. So what is the importance of Stefanini Indian growing in our NA and APAC region?
India today is the engine of growth that we have in North America.
Okay.
Because of the big offers that we have, the most important offers that we have are here. They are in India, services provided in India. So every growth that we are having passed through India.
Okay.
So very important. Actually, India is in the center of the growth strategy for North America APAC.
Okay.
Like, because I told you before, North America APAC is the most important region for the Stefanini Group, then you can see the correlation. So India, it's very, very important to North America APAC, and it's very, very important to the Stefanini Group in overall.
Okay. So what is the strategy to grow our company in India?
Our go-to-market and our sales strategy, it's selling services to American companies.
Okay.
We deliver the services from here. But we also think and look into the domestic market, the Indian domestic market, for us to start expanding the sales to the Indian territory. So what I'm trying to say is not only provide services to offshore, but also going to the local market here, getting clients, local clients, closing contracts, signing contracts, and delivering services here locally. So in that sense, one part of the strategy will be growing the business locally as well, not only linked it to US, but locally too.
Okay. So what is our goal for the next 5 years for India?
For India is keep growing, sustaining the business that we're doing. Like I said, all the growth has to be with India. So in order to do that, I need to keep attracting talent, retaining talent, growing the people here, giving them career opportunity, giving them opportunity to learn something else, a new technology, expanding and evolving personally and professionally. In that sense, the rest it common activities. You have to adjust the size of offices, etc., provide more infrastructure. But the reality is how I attract and retain the talent.
Why Stefanini India, and why the differentiation between the areas, and what inspired you to expand Stefanini India operations in India, and what have you been the main benefits?
Okay, so it's a big three questions in one. Differentiate. So why India?
Yeah.
Because the talent that exists here, the skill level that exists here. People here are very, very good in technology. You know, you guys are famous for, you know, love to learn, love to study, and then you apply all that knowledge on the work. So the skills here are abundant. The availability of skills, because you're a big country, so you have a lot of people. So, you know, the skills here can be found different than in some countries that you cannot find the skills. So India, it's because of that. It used to be in the past, to be very honest, used to be in the past also attractive from a cost perspective, you know. Well, that benefit of offshoring and salary arbitration was absorbed already. So it's a commodity already. So you don't look at India anymore because of price point. You look at India because of a talent pool that exists here. Now, what inspires me and Stefanini to keep growing and investing here? It's because of our people.
Okay.
It's because of the Stefanini people that we work every day here in India. It's because of your culture.
Okay.
It's because of your kindness. It's because of your devotion, passion to the business. It's because of your willingness to serve and help others. I think it has to be with technology in some degree, but has to be with your culture and how you guys are as human beings. You are a nation that is kind and love to work, and technology and services, the business that we are, has everything to do in being, you know, empathic and help others, and willing to help, willing to understand, to listen, and then transform problems into solutions throughout technology. So it's the people.
Okay.
Definitely it's the people.
So are there any unique aspects of Indian culture that make the country a particular good fit for Stephanie?
Yeah, I think we talk a little bit about that. I think I want to like to elaborate a little more. When you are providing services, you have to listen.
Yeah.
You have to listen, because when you listen to clients and then you understand what they need, then you can craft a solution that's going to help them to overcome the challenges. In order to stop and listen, you have to be humble and put yourself in that position. And you know, your culture is very aligned with that mentality of helping others, to collaborate, to listen to be kind, to love to help, love to work with. So I believe those are the key aspects of the culture. Besides the fact, I'm going to reinforce that, besides the fact that you guys have a tremendous skill set, you're very intelligent, very capable in all the technologies. There's no technology in the market that you come here to India and you don't find specialists.
Yeah.
So I want to make clear that is your skills from a technology perspective, but also your character as human being that makes this very unique professional, Indian professional. Companies that are not understanding that, I believe is they are losing the opportunity to work with the Indian country and community. And I can tell you, I know that there's differences, culture, language, but we have been working with, you know, Indians from the north, from the south,
yes.
and they all equal in kindness and intelligence and knowledge and technology.
Wonderful. So about the moonlight culture that has taken over employees these days, what is your perspective about it?
Yeah, this is a delicate topic. Although there's nothing against the law, we believe that in Stephanini, the way that we provide services, I don't think it goes into the best interest of the company, our clients, and our employees, by the way. Think, we work focused on U.S. time zone. So you see that we work a little bit shifted,
yes,
to support U.S. Time zones.
Yeah.
So what I'm trying to say is all the clients are working at the same period of time. You're doing, you know, you're moonlighting, meaning you're taking double shift. In reality, it's going to mean that you're going to try to do two jobs at the same time.
Yeah.
And this is what we believe, it's not going to work. It's impossible. It has conflict of interests. So we don't support in Stephanini. We don't believe that the employees can then give their best.
Yeah, true.
I think you can have, instead of one great employee, you can end up losing that professional,
yes,
because of that type of practice. So again, it's not against the law. But we don't believe that it's a fit to our culture. It's not going into the, you know, best interest of us and our.
Okay. So moving on further, with your professional and personal work.
Okay.
So how do you prioritize your tasks? And are there any kind of tools or techniques that you use?
That's funny. I'm against meetings.
Okay.
My time it's prioritized first to the people.
Mm-hmm.
It's my job be close to people. It's my job make sure that the strategy that we develop, it permeates the entire organization.
Mm-hmm.
So I need to make sure that what I'm talking to my executive leadership team, it's going, it's cascading down to the entire organization. This is why, you know, I'm here. I'm here visiting, doing meetings, one-on-ones, group meetings. It's the best way that I double check if the message that I, you know, gave on the top is getting and permeating the entire organization. So my priority are our people and our customers.
Okay.
And taking care of these two aspects, I'll make sure that the strategy is aligned and then the business will succeed.
Okay. So as a leader, how do you encourage and foster diversity, equality, and inclusion in your terms?
Yeah, I think it's so clear for us in Stefanini. We look for talent.
Okay.
We look for talent. We don't look for nationality, race, color, sexual orientation, religion.
Mm-hmm.
We look for talent. Where the talent is where we're going. So embraced all the minorities, all the diversities, everybody, you know, we work to give everybody same opportunities in terms of deploy their talent and their willingness to succeed here in the company.
Okay. So what is that one childhood or teenage habit that remains with you till date?
Read. You know, my mother is a tremendous reader, and I think I learned watching her read. And till the day, I'm always with a book around me.
Oh, wonderful. What's the important risk you have ever taken and why?
Moving out of my home country, I think it was a risk.
Okay.
You cannot deny, right? You're leaving your family behind, you're leaving your culture, you're leaving your mother tongue, and you're now projecting yourself and moving to a unknown territory from a culture perspective, geographically, language, etc. So I did twice.
Okay.
I don't regret. I think these two times were right decisions that I made. That gave me the opportunity to know amazing people and work with amazing clients, people, understanding culture, learning languages.
Yeah.
So I'm very glad that those risks that I took.
Okay. So Spencer, let's lighten the mood a little. And then just let's play a rapid fire round with you.
Okay.
Okay?
Oh my.
Just one word. You have just one word to say.
Doctor. Okay.
So one thing that annoys Spencer.
Injustice.
Good. What's the most interesting, important thing in your wallet or purse?
Nothing.
There should be something.
Not in my wallet.
What could it be, if not your wallet?
I think it's in a family.
Oh, that's nice. Who is the person you talk to when you need a listening ear?
I think my wife, Gladys is one. My dad.
Good. If you could be the character on TV show, what character would you want to be and why?
I like, he's not a character, but I like Jim Fallon.
Oh.
He does interviews. So I always look to this guy, like, oh, he has a chance to talk to so many amazing people that, you know, I kind of jealous about. His job is doing something fun.
Okay.
And he has the opportunity to meet so many great people. So, yeah. If I have a wish one day, like having a interview TV show like that one.
That's nice. One thing you would like to stop, pause, and start about Stephanie?
I would like to there's nothing. I'm thinking about stopping anything in Stefanini. Pause. We're in such a great moment in Stefanini this years, but you know, if I could, I would love to stop of any of our employees to get sick.
Okay.
I would pause. I would pause the. I would pause, you know, crisis that we are facing in different countries that we are.
Mm-hmm.
We're in 41 countries, so
yeah.
We're always exposed to something in some countries. Might be political, geographical issues, etc. So I would like to pause that. And start, I just want to start growing in another country, in another region.
Okay. What do you say when you answer the phone?
I say hi.
Okay. Describe yourself in one word.
Dreamer.
Good. What's your favorite joke?
Oh, the funny one. I love jokes.
Do you cook?
Yeah.
And what do you specialize in?
That's not very aligned with Indian culture in average, but I love barbecue.
Oh, good.
I'm Brazilian, remember that?
Yeah.
And we love barbecue.
Your hobby?
I do sports.
Great. What do you love to eat for your breakfast?
Eggs.
Good. Do you have any nicknames?
I had when I was young, my name was always tough to be said in Portuguese. So they were calling me, and my family still call me Pence, which is just a shortage of Spencer.
Oh, that's nice. So anyway, Spencer, it was lovely talking to you and knowing about you.
Likewise.
Your thoughts about the organization and your life as well. Thank you so much for giving your time.
Well, thanks for the opportunity.
Thank you. On this note, we sign off.